Ah, das kriege ich von bassstable.com, and in this video we're checking four different sets of DR bass strings. I've been using those strings for many, many years and I really appreciate their quality, their sound and their amazing durability. The company was founded in 1989 by Marc Dranche, who is actually the son of the guy who founded Guild Guitars. So the beat of music was in the veins of the family for generations already. The company is still owned and run by Marc and his family, and what's actually very interesting about DR strings is that they're making strings only and nothing else, nothing at all. That means no tuners, no accessories, as almost all other string manufacturers do, just to sell more products to their clients. But the DR guys told me they just want to focus on strings and push the envelope there and just make sure to stay ahead of the game and just focus on their core business. And I think this is actually an amazing choice. They're based in New Jersey, and what I found actually very surprising is that they're still hand winding every single string they're producing. And this seems almost a little bit outdated today, but the quality that they can achieve with this is very different to any other product on the market, and they're so concerned about the quality and the best possible product they can make that they're just always willing to walk this extra mile. This also shows in a different topic because basically they're sourcing all the materials they're using to produce the strings out of the US. They could import steel and other materials much cheaper from abroad, of course, but they want the best quality they can get, and they will always be willing to pay the extra buck. And so this is the core, the wire, the ball ends, even the packaging is from the US, so this is insane. They're inspecting each and every wrap of every string before they package them and send them out, and they even train their workers for at least half a year before they can work in actually in a production line and make strings on themselves. And in times of fast markets and globalization, I find this is a very, very interesting approach, but at the end, I think the quality of the strings speaks for themselves. However, let's get started with the review. I have four sets. We have the Sunbeams, we have Lowriders, we have the Pure Blues, and we have High Beams. And let's get started with the High Beams, because these are basically the strings that got DR started and also got me started with using the strings. DR High Beam strings were back in the days developed in cooperation with Marcus Miller, and I absolutely love this guy, like I guess most of you. He has a very unique sound, he has great playing style, he plays very unique music, and it's just a brilliant figure in the bass world. But I personally never associated with this kind of sound for my sound, for that what I was looking for. And this was only until a friend of mine just handed me over a jazz bass where he just put a set of those strings on, and I got to play it and I was just blown away. They are very bright and punchy, but still have a good portion of great sounding mids, and when I was playing then I actually sounded nothing like Marcus. They're stainless steel strings constructed around a round core, and that's why they're actually very punchy, but at the same time also very flexible. Later I found out that a lot of rock and metal guys are using them too, and what I personally appreciate about them is how open and how direct they sound. I'm using them on my Sandberg California TT Masterpiece bass all the time, and this bass with the strings really comes to life, and even if they're months old, they still sound absolutely amazing. Pure Blue strings are quantum nickels with a round core wire, and they sound nice and very warm. And they're actually the reason why this bass sounds the way it sounds. This is the bassstable.com signature by Alice Visual Deal that I just reviewed. Basically, if you play them hard, they're super punchy, they have brights, they have enough treble, they're just great. And if you play them soft or use palm muting techniques, they get nice and warm and fat. And this is a very wide range, which is very unusual. And I think this bass wouldn't sound like this without these strings. I find it especially interesting that we're often recording very warm sounding mid and bass heavy P-bass sounds with this bass, but at the same time these are the strings that also Victor Wooten is using on his Federa basses, and he sounds bright and he sounds brilliant and has all these little sound details in his sound, and I think it's amazing that one string can deliver such a wide range of different sounds and still work brilliant. And I think these are the best strings that I've ever tried on this bass and are in general great for P-bass stuff, but again, Victor Wooten is using them for something completely different. So if you're looking for a flexible string feel, but looking at the same time for a warm but also punchy sound, just try them out. Sunbeams are nickel-plated steel strings with a round core, and for me they are just the most perfect match for jazz basses with rosewood fingerboards. I don't have one currently, so we can't demo this to you, but if you own a 60s type of jazz bass, just put them on and be surprised. I highly recommend to check them out. Like most other strings, they're very bright at the beginning, but if you just put them on the bass, play it for a little bit so they lose their first sing, what you will be left with by then is a lot of warmth, a lot of mids, a lot of basses, which just sounds amazing, but it's still very defined and has a great punch, but it's just, for me, it's like the perfect kind of vintage sound. So it's not too dull, it's not like flat wound, it's actually completely on the different side of the range, but it's not too bright, not too harsh, it's just so beautiful in between. And again, if you own a jazz bass with a rosewood fingerboard, just put them on. I think this is just a match made in heaven. For me, the most impressive thing about Sunbeams is how long they last and how long you can leave them on your bass. I had sets that were for more than 6 months on my bass, and I just only changed them because I felt like these are regular round-on strings. They're not protected like coated, so you have to change them. But actually, they still were in their sound. They still sounded amazing, and it's just more like a feeling like I have to do it now than it was actually necessary to change them. It's almost like flat wound strings. You can basically play them forever. Of course, they will lose some character and tone over time, but I think they still sound great, and 6 months, this is an insane time for round one strings. The sounds that we recorded for this video here, of course, these strings were completely fresh on the bass by then, and of course they're very bright. So if you want to hear them, what they sound like in a later stage, just watch out on this channel for a video with this bass here. This is an old Sandberg California TT masterpiece that I used to have, rosewood fingerboard, 60s pickup spacing, and man, this bass and these strings, it's just a thing of beauty. Lowrider strings are actually very similar to the high beams, only that they are a lot stiffer. And they use a stainless steel wrap over a hexagon core wire, and I personally find them very useful, especially for drop tunings, because if you tune your bass lower, they have just a higher string tension and will still feel great with this. The most prominent user is Sting, and he's definitely not a rock or metal guy, but actually I have to say, people that are using those strings around me are playing mostly like harder stuff. Guys from DR Strings say that the lowriders are actually very accurate strings, and they recommend them for slap stuff, for tapping, and especially for anything where harmonics are involved. I personally, I don't have too much experience with that, I have to say. These are the only strings out of the bunch that I didn't use for a longer time on any of my basses. Not because I don't like them, it just never happened for some reason. However, the consistency with DR strings and their durability and their quality is so outstanding that I don't doubt that these are just as good as any other string set that we've just tried. Yeah, and I guess that's just it for today. If you enjoyed this review, don't hesitate to hit the like button below, subscribe to our channel if you want to see more of those, and otherwise, I wish you a wonderful weekend and see you next time. Bye bye.